Welcome back to another edition of Mobile Mix. This week we are here at the Barclays Center in New York City for Samsung's Galaxy Unpacked 2019 event. It rained cats and dogs outside, but that did not dampen the spirits inside as Samsung took the wraps off its new Galaxy Note 10 smartphone. The device, for the first time ever, comes in two different sizes, has a whole slew of new camera features, as well as 5G variants, and we are going to tell you all about it.
As in the past, Samsung piled on the upgrades in its Note update. The Note 10's new Infinity display all but ditches bezels at the top and bottom of the screen and comes with a fingerprint reader tucked underneath. A new camera setup on the rear of the device features three or four lenses depending on the model, and alongside upgraded software enables new tools including AR Doodle, 3D scanning, and screen recording. Meanwhile, an updated S Pen will support new gesture controls and transform handwritten notes to text. Under the hood, Samsung added double the storage capacity, bigger batteries, and a Snapdragon 855 processor. But perhaps the biggest change was Samsung's decision to offer the device in two sizes for the first time ever, a move creative strategies analyst Carolina Milanese said could help expand its user base.
It was interesting to see the two different sizes of the Note. I think we need to remember that we're 10 years in with Note, and we've moved really from a target market for mostly male and really early tech adopters to a broader base of users. And women want to be as productive as men want, but maybe they're a little put off by the larger size of the device. I also think that pen input has become more widespread, so having that option of both price and size is going to help broaden the base.
At the Note 10 launch, Samsung also talked up a new collaboration with Microsoft, which it said will help bridge the gap between mobile devices and PCs. As part of the arrangement, Samsung said the Note 10 will come preloaded with a suite of Microsoft apps, including one which will allow users to access photos, texts, and apps from their mobile device on their Windows 10 desktop. Related updates to Samsung's DeX mobile to PC interface are also on the way.
Another week and another set of Huawei headlines, and the company has officially announced its homegrown operating system, dubbed HarmonyOS or HongmengOS in Chinese. The announcement was made at its developer conference, and it declared it can be used on a variety of devices, such as smartphones, smartwatches, and in-vehicle systems. Now, Huawei's move follows concern it will be banned from using future versions of Android. The company said the OS will first launch in China, with plans to roll it out globally. Earlier this week, Chinese media reported that Huawei planned to release its first smartphone running on its own in-house OS by the end of this year. Now, sticking with Huawei, the world's largest mobile network vendor announced plans to invest $1.4 billion in a massive new R&D center in Shanghai. The under-fire vendor, facing trade bans from the US and a number of other countries due to security concerns, is attempting to become less reliant on imports. Finally, the CEO of Telia, Johan Dennelind, tendered his resignation this week, although the European operator will have at least a year to recruit his successor. The current CEO has a 12-month notice period, meaning he will not step down until sometime in 2020. Among the most significant programs overseen by the CEO were an exit from operations outside its core Nordic and Baltic markets, a merger with TDC Norway, and the acquisition of Bonnier Broadcasting. He was also a major supporter of the UN's Sustainable Development Goals.
That's all for now. We'll be back with Samsung again next week as Justin pays a visit to their new Experience Center in the heart of London. We'll see you then.